This video will cover the topic, Introduction to the Least Common Multiple of Two Monomials. Before we start finding the least common multiple of monomials, let's first start out with explaining the definition. The least common multiple of two or more integers is the least whole number that each integer divides with no remainder. This can be applied to expressions in the same way. Let's first look at an example with just integers by finding the least common multiple of 8, 14, and 7. We start by listing the prime factors of each number. Breaking 8 down into its prime factors using the tree method illustrates that the prime factors are 2 times 2 times 2. Doing the same for 14, we see that its prime factors are 7 and 2. Last, we see that 7 doesn't break down past 7 times 1. Remember that 1 is not a prime factor, so we disregard it in these problems. Therefore, the prime factor of 7 is just 7.
Okay, now what?
Now, we will use each factor listed the greatest number of times it occurs in each number. For example, the factor 2 occurs 3 times for 8, once for 14, and not at all in 7. So when finding the least common multiple, we will use 2 as a factor 3 times. Also, 7 occurs once in 7 and once in 14, so we will multiply 7 by the previous result. Thus, we get that the least common multiple of 8, 14, and 7 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 7, which equals 56.
So that's how you find the least common multiple of 3 integers. But how would we find the least common multiple of 2 monomials?
The process is very similar. We can work together through an example. Let's find the least common multiple of 6x cubed y to the 5th and 8x squared y to the 6th. Given these two monomials, we are going to find the largest numbers of instances that occur for 2, 3, x, and y. Starting with 2, you can see that the second monomial has 2 occurring 3 times as a prime factor, so 2 times 2 times 2 is included in determining the least common multiple. 3 only occurs in the first monomial, so it is only included once in calculating the least common multiple.
So, if x occurs 3 times in the first monomial and 2 times in the second, we should include x 3 times in the final calculation.
Yes, exactly. Last, y occurs 6 times in the second monomial, which is greater than 5, so it is included 6 times in the least common multiple. Combining everything, we get 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times x times x times x times y times y times y times y times y times y. This simplifies to 24x cubed y to the 6th.
So, in order to find the least common multiple of 2 monomials, we use the factor of each monomial however many times it occurs most often amongst the 2 monomials.
Yep, exactly. It looks like you really understand how to find the least common multiple of 2 monomials.